Right, hopefully you can hear me now. I'm just giving you a heart attack there, Mark, as I get started. Welcome, everybody. Great to see you online. I can kind of start, I can see to the right here all the different names of everybody that's here, and I can see some people are joining us, but we're over 105, which is good. I'm sure a few more to come. I guess I'm the warm-up act tonight as people start turning up. I'm Mr. Scanlon, as you know, the head teacher. But you'll also hear from Simon Davies, who has the hard task of putting our timetable together every year. So he's probably the most important person that you're going to hear from tonight in terms of how it works, how the whole process works. And then we'll hear from Mr. Monaghan, who's in charge of our sixth form and also the technical wizard that makes it all work at the moment, as we're in this virtual world. So let me tell you what I'd really love to get out of this evening in terms of our aims. Normally we'd be in the hall, and normally I'd say to you, or in the theatre, and I think it's always an important moment in your educational career, year nine, and for all the families, really. So we'll recognise the milestone and take a second to think about where we're at. I do want to talk to you about the 2-year Key Stage 4 and what the EBAC is and what's influencing us in terms of how we put our timetable together, our curriculum together, essentially. Those key dates, Simon's going to talk to you about the key dates, the process, how to complete it, how to get through the next, you know, few weeks as to make sure that we all land in the right place. And then I guess ultimately, what you're really going to want to do tonight is have a good conversation with our subject leaders and our curriculum directors. And they'll be on hand from 6:30. Now, even if it's not just about choosing the subjects, that's not the only reason you need to speak to them. It's also about getting an idea of what you'll be studying over the next 2 years. And you're going to want to hit the ground running. Okay, most of the teaching happens in year 10, believe it or not. So it's a good chance to have a chat about what the curriculum entails for you over the next 2 years. So facts and information, and hopefully a chance to ask lots of questions later on of our teachers. And you'll see the technology will facilitate that. Okay, so let's mark the moment. I don't know. I can't remember. Do year nine, do you remember your very first day at primary school? At reception? I bet all the parents remember. I bet you remember the nursery. I doubt the students do, but you probably have a vague memory of going to your first day of primary school. But I think everybody here remembers, even the parents, will remember their first day at secondary school as we come into Key Stage 3. And there you are. And you've kind of come to the end of Key Stage 3 now, and it is one of these big moments. Up until now, everything's been quite controlled. The national curriculum, you've been following it. It's a big achievement, honestly. If you think about what you were capable of doing on that first day at reception, at that first day of secondary school, you have come a long, long way. And particularly during this last year, I've been looking at your attendance the whole way, and you've done really well, year nine, really, really well. And hopefully we're going to put that to good use, all that independence you've developed and the ability to kind of push yourself. We're going to make really good use of that over the next 2 years. So this is the beginning of where we start to specialise just a little bit for the next 2 years, but then really significantly as we go into the sixth form, into university or training, or indeed into employment. So this is the bit where we start to kind of what Mr. Davis calls a fork in the road. This is where that's about to happen in earnest. Okay, so let me talk to you for a second about the English Baccalaureate. This is a term, I guess, that's slipped into the English education system over the last 5 to 7 years. It doesn't mean anything more than this combination of subjects. This is what we call it, this qualification. So you're studying English language and literature, maths, the sciences. And if you're doing triple science or double science, that's not part of the options process tonight. So don't worry about that. That's not part of the timetable. If you're doing triple science, that's something we do anyway. So don't worry. That's not part of tonight, okay? Geography or history and a language. So those combinations of subjects is what we call the English Baccalaureate. And we're currently way above our target of 75%. The national target, believe it or not, frozen in a very awkward facial pose there. Will that come back? Hopefully you can still hear me. The national ambition is to get to 90% of the country doing English baccalaureate, believe it or not. And, you know, it's something that I actually agree with myself. I think the English baccalaureate combination of subjects keep all the doors open. It's definitely the norm to stay in education nowadays, or education and training, until 18. And the English baccalaureate is a great way of continuing to improve your literacy, your numeracy, and to develop your knowledge and understanding of the world around you. It's also, in my opinion, the best preparation for Key Stage 5. And I'd also say that it's the best way to navigate how the GCSEs have been set up since 2015 and 2016. So let's have a look and see if my slides are still working. They are. Okay, so let's talk about the GCSEs for a second. They are definitely designed with the EBAC in mind. You'll see you're going to hear the word progress aid quite a bit, I suppose, over the next 2 years. It's just how we evaluate the students and evaluate the progress that they're making. But just to kind of give you a very basic, and we can do this again when we're in the same space, but just to give you a very basic introduction to this, you can see there by looking at buckets, if we go back from one mark, sorry, that English and maths are double weighted, just kind of recognizing the importance of those two subjects. And then we take the next three best grades from the sciences, computer science, languages, geography, or history. Okay, so your three next best grades. And then the final bucket is three grades from any other approved qualifications. Okay, so it's a combination of those buckets that and an average that comes up with the progress aid score. So that's that. You can see that the English baccalaureate is very much in mind when they reformed the GCSEs. Thanks, Mark. I have to do a Chris Whitty. Next slide, please. Right, now let me just tell you a little bit about these GCSEs that you're about to embark on, year nine. I would say that they are, we're kind of in this groove now for a while, but I would say that they are more demanding. So especially parents, if you've had children go through before 2015, 2016, I think the GCSEs definitely are more demanding than they were in the past. And it's just more content. They're also linear, so which means that you're doing most of the exams at the end of the course. And also all the non-exam assessment, you know, what we often call coursework, has been, I'd say, mostly removed or reduced in the majority of GCSEs. So it is quite tough. You have to, you know, you're definitely going to have to stay with it the whole time. You're going to have to study quite hard. There's a lot of content. The other thing that'll be new to some of you is this sense of, it's no longer letters, we're now going to numbers. So the grading scale is 9 to 1, 9 being the best grade. I'll show you a graph of that in a second. And I think it's also important to say that there are two tiers of entry for Spanish, French, mathematics, and science. So you've got a foundation paper, which is the highest grade you're going to get there is a 5, or a higher paper, so grades 4 to 9. So really with those two tiers of entry, it means that everybody should be able to access these subjects. Thanks, Mark. So this is just that graphic to show you how in the past you would have been used to this grading system on the right here with the A star. They were kind of running out of stars, I think. So as the standards were rising, it was just easier, I think, to move to numbers. Works better with the system generally. So just for, you know, to give you a kind of idea, anything above a 7 would be like an old A. Anything above a 4 is a pass. Anything above a 5 is a good pass. Okay, so everybody should be aiming for 5s and above. They're very strong passes. Okay, so just to kind of bring that all together before I hand over to Mr. Davies, you can see that this is why we've set things up the way we have. And so everybody will do, of course, do English language, literature. Everybody will do maths, the sciences. Everybody will do PE. Everybody will do the National Curriculum Requirement of Religion. But what you're going to choose tonight is either history or geography. You're going to choose either French or Spanish, or you're going to choose one of the subjects from Block C, and all those teachers are available for you this evening to have a good chat with. Now, the target is 75% because I know some of you feel very strongly about not doing a language, which is okay. You know, that is okay. But we'll want to make sure that you're making the right choices as an alternative. So if you're not doing a language, you're going to want to have a conversation with us about what you are going to do instead, just to get that right. But what I'll do at this stage is I'll just hand over to Dr. Davis, who I have to say, Brother Davis has to put together an enormous timetable. We teach over 50,000 lessons in a year with over 1,200 students. So the combination of putting them all together is more mean feat. So over to you, Simon. Take us through the next.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Simon Davis. For students, it's possibly the biggest moment in terms of your education so far. You've got to that fork in the road moment where the choices that you decide in terms of your options will determine which pathway you'll go down in terms of future qualifications and a future career. So when actually making your choices, what's really important is that you need to find out as much as possible about the subject, and also what jobs that you want to do. If you've got a clear idea about the job you want to do, then you'll be able to choose the correct qualifications that will suit you. So in terms of that, we've got a lot of information, advice and guidance available for students. So really, the key thing tonight is the options evening. After tonight's main presentation, you've then got the opportunity to speak to subject teachers to find out what really the courses entail, because they may be different in terms of the structure and content from what you've currently experienced. So it's important that you get an idea of those. We've had online career sessions that have been going on this week during tutor time in Google Classroom. So for the students, if you haven't accessed those already, it's really important that you get onto Google Classroom tomorrow and that you really engage with the resources. There's questionnaires, there's videos, and you can actually find out through using those resources what possible careers you're suited to. It might open up avenues in terms of what you'll possibly be interested in. And you have all been set up a start profile by the careers team, and it's really important that you actually engage in that. And if you're not too sure how it works, when we're back in school next week, please feel free to ask either Mrs. Morley in the careers team or come down to chapter and ask us, and we'll be able to help. And also, I know that Mr. Monaghan's put a huge amount of detail on the school website. So when you go to the website later on, there'll be information that's been written by the subject leaders for each subject. And also they've put a short video together as well, which explains what you actually get out of the course in more detail. So it is worth using all of that. Now, as Mr. Scanlon said, here are the three option blocks. And from tomorrow, the options form will be available online for you to fill in. When you're actually choosing your options, you'll need to choose one subject from each of the blocks. And we'll also be asking you to do a reserve choice. And it's important that the reserve choice can come from any of those blocks. So it's just one subject from any of those blocks. So you can choose that reserve choice. We also, to help us, if you've got an idea of what career or job you like to do, it's really important that you put that in as well. So there'll be a space for you to put that in. And when we actually come to do the options, most people will get their first choices. If there are any issues at all throughout the options process, we are very good at communicating with you. So if there are any issues, we'll let you know. In the case of courses maybe being way oversubscribed, we'd let you know. So in terms of the next steps, so these are the next steps that are available to you. Right, the first thing is making sure you go to the options pages on the website, and particularly after the main presentation tonight, you've got the opportunity to speak to the subject leaders and ask them questions about what the course entails, and to get a broader idea of the course. And so particularly if you're not sure, it's well worth speaking to those subject leaders tonight. And in terms of questions about individual students' suitability for courses, you've got a real good opportunity next week to speak to the subject teachers at the parents' evening. So it's making sure that you book appointment for next Thursday. And if there are any issues with making appointments next week, if you're not available for any reason, please do let us know at the chapter team and we'll be able to get your teachers to contact you. Okay, next slide, please. So the key thing is that the options form needs to be completed by Monday the 29th of March. That's the Monday of the last week of term. So fortunately, we're back in school next week. So if there's any problems at all, any questions, please do contact us in the chapter team and we'll be more than happy to help. And it's important that you really carefully thought about your choices before submitting the form. Because if you make a change after the deadline, we don't want you to miss out on the subject. So it's important that you make it. But if you're not sure, please do come down to chapter. And parents will finally be informed of the final choices by Friday the 9th of July. But having said that, if there are any issues in the meantime, we will communicate it. So when you get that final notification, there won't be any surprises there. Okay, so I'm now going to hand over to Mr. Monaghan.
Thank you, Mr. Davies. And thank you, everyone, for patience. There's a few comments in the chat that some technical issues. So I'm going to talk you through some technical things now so that you can actually go and explore the subject areas. And if there was any problems you had now getting on this session or you've come in at the end, then this presentation actually will be available on the SRWA YouTube channel. So it's broadcasting there live now. So you'll be able to go to pop back there, and once it's finished, there'll be a recording of it. So anything you've missed, you want to catch again, then you can go and have a look at that. So I'm just going to talk you through now just the next practical steps to help you make the most of the rest of this evening. So normally we'd have you in school, you'd have a talk from exactly the same Mr. Scanlon and Mr. Davies, but the idea then would be that you'd go into a bit of a marketplace, but obviously we can't do that right now. So we've kind of created a virtual marketplace. So there will be from 6:30 through to 7:30, a whole load of subject Q&A sessions. So pretty much, it's pretty much just got to be an opportunity for you to go around the different rooms and speak to the different teachers. There's no specific timings, so it's not like this. It's not a presentation. It's just a chance for you to pop into the room and then ask questions about the subjects, maybe your child's suitability for the course, maybe what the course involves. So you've made it this far, so which means that's a good step. You've managed to sign in, but I will also be here at the end if there's any technical issues. But you will then come out of the room from here. There is a little exit sign on the bottom left. There's a little exit door you can leave. And then you'll be back in the lobby where you can then choose the different subject areas. So you will see all the different subjects listed. And then you can click on join now. So these are all, it says preview here, but they are now live from 6:30. So once they're live, you'll be able to go in and actually then go and have a chat to the subject teachers. If you are on a mobile phone or a tablet, it will look a little bit different. So you'll see something probably closer to this. Ignore the fact that it says test, do not enter. I just wanted to make sure that anyone came on this yesterday, they wouldn't try and turn up. But you'll see the name of the subject where that first arrow is. And then there's a big button that says join. So you'll be able to just go into that room, join. It may ask you then just to check your camera and your mic. Don't worry, you don't have to speak if you don't want to. But then when you do get into those sessions, you've got a couple of options. So if you are on the app, you'll find down the bottom, there's the little chat bar. So lots of you have been putting chat messages in already. So we've kind of got that cracked. But there's also a little picture of a hand holding a microphone. And that's a bit like maybe you get, you know, you see these kind of conferences, someone asks for the mic and then they get to stand up and speak. So you can request the mic. And then a staff member in there would then allow you to speak, and that would kind of allow you to turn your camera and your audio on. So you've got two options there, chat or request the mic. So that's how it looks in the app. And then on the website, if you're joining us via a desktop or a laptop, it's pretty much the same. You've got the chat on the right and then the grab the mic button on the left. And then it will just be a matter of you might end up in a queue. So other people might be let forward, and you just go in order so that no one can push in when you're asking questions. And then obviously you're not going to stick around in those rooms for a full hour. You'll want to move on to other sessions. So then you can then just go down to the little red exit door at the bottom left of the page if you are on a computer, ready to exit, and just exit. You can always come back at any time. So leaving isn't permanent, so you can come back up to the lobby, go to a session. You might see it's a bit busy, come back, go somewhere else. And then if you're, of course, if you're on the app, then you can also, whoops, if you're on the app, you'll see there, you see there's a little kind of icon. So at the top left, there is just a little back arrow that lets you navigate away from that page instead of that little door icon. So then, what next? So this is the bit, you've kind of had your chance to have a chat, have a look around. So it's just bringing all this together. And part of my role is that, as well as being in charge of the sixth form and all this technology that sometimes works and doesn't, is also the career stuff. So we have put a lot of stuff on Google Classroom this week for tutor time. So we've talked students through the process. We had Chloe Bassett join us, who was a former student, who talked to us about her experiences of being at university. We then have a massive careers platform, which allows students to explore different careers. And there's some activities that have taken them through talking about GCSEs, looking at different pathways, the impact of making different choices, and then allows them to see the connection between different subjects and different jobs. You can give them a thumbs up, thumbs down, and the system adapts to give different recommendations based on that. So it actually is a really worthwhile process to go through. So all of those activities are still on the Year 9 Google Classroom. So if students have missed them this week, they will be there for the rest of the, you know, for the rest of the term, really. So up until the date when these forms are due, the students can go back in. And we really do recommend that, as Kieran said at the beginning, it's one of the first times that, you know, this is a big kind of critical point where you want to make a really well-informed decision. So using that information is step one. We've then also had all our subject leaders work together to produce a short video for you. So you can ask questions now, but then there's also a short video on our website with information about the subjects and also just kind of written content. So that's just at slwa.woodard.co.uk/options. Pretty easy to find, hopefully. And then you'll go through and you'll see there's a whole load of resources on that page, including direct links to all the subject information. So you can see them all here. And then clicking through, you'll see on those pages, they'll start off with at the top, there's a nice little video from the subject leader. And then beneath that is some more detail on those courses. So with the start profile, the careers activities, all that stuff during tutor time, the Q&A today, and then all those resources on the website, treat them a little bit like a digital prospectus, really. So we've been able to really quickly get together some content that we would normally give to you on paper that you can then take away, have a look at your leisure, and then ask questions and really, you know, have a conversation with your child about the kind of things they're interested in, what they want to do, where they want to go. And that website then will update overnight. So some point tomorrow, that options page will be 80% the same, but then the actual options form itself will be embedded into that page. And that will be the place where you submit your child's preferences. And obviously we said, choose a subject from every column, but then also a reserve. And when you do fill that form in, it is timestamped. So that means that your kind of order is maintained. So you will be able to kind of make sure that you're in the queue. So if you get it in first, then you're able to be at the top of the line, so to speak. And then if there's any issues, as Simon said, we can look at your second choice. And so that form will appear tomorrow, pretty easy. Child's name, child's subjects they want to choose. There's a question at the end about careers. And that's pretty much it. And that will all get crunched in a massive big 1960s style computer with whirring wheels by Simon. And then we'll look at groupings and everything else to make sure everyone gets their first choice. And then there'll be conversations about whether people need to move different options based on availability. So that is pretty much it from this part of it. So we said half an hour this first part, so we're pretty much bang on. So it gives you a few minutes to maybe stretch your legs, and then the subject leader teams will be available out in the lobby from 6:30. So we'll say goodbye to you from here, and this session here will end. But I will stick around for a couple of minutes just in case anyone has any technical questions, if they're having issues accessing any of the other events. So thank you for your time. We hope it's an enjoyable evening. I'm loving seeing all the emojis coming up. It's, you know, where would we be without emojis? Emma, thank you for the feedback. Glad that it was really clear. And, you know, hopefully you have everything you need now. You've got the people to talk to and all the information on the website. So thank you for your time. Have a good evening, and we will see you soon. Thanks very much.